private airplane, and it went pools in all their houses. That's where the money's going.
These people
are making $150 million and more a year and never get enough. And these are the people who have bought and paid for our government that is supposed to be our government. So what we are here to do is to establish a participatory government of people working together for people and community and for the planet.
Tarek, we got 12.
And for our children, for future generations.
Tarek,
won't have future generations if we don't do something.
I missed all the first part of this. This is the live stream. We got over 1,200 people now watching live at this moment. So, and Tarek Kalf has been one of the organizers here. Tell me, I missed the first.
How many people are watching this?
1,200 people and plus. 1,200 people are watching right now. So tell me what your thoughts are on all this.
I think this is a great manifestation of a people's democratic movement. These are people who are here who are demanding peace. They are demanding sustainability. They're demanding housing. They're demanding schooling and education. They're making all these demands. And they are demanding an end to war as an instrument of foreign policy. They are demanding an end to the drain of our dollars, the people's money, work, sweat, and tears going into the pockets of the billionaires who are controlling this corporate government and this corporatocracy. They are demanding an end to that because these people are destroying our democracy, they're destroying the planet, and it has got to stop. We want a sustainable universe, and we're here to stop business as usual. And that's what's going on all over the country.
I know, it's pretty
you
amazing.
You see it all over the country because the people have had enough of being controlled by billionaires who are sending our sons and daughters to wars to fight and to devastate and occupy other countries, and at the same time are waging a war on the poor, the people of color here, the immigrants in this country. We don't even have health care. They don't want to give us anything.
No, they want to take things away that people already have.
They are taking away everything. And that's why the people are making a stand in this country. And this is part of that. And we're going to do this again and again and again and again until things change. And we do not expect them to change. They are not going to change. This is the power structure. We are going to force them nonviolently to change. We are going to nonviolently force change. That is what you see here. That's what the people are doing. And if you notice, if you look around, and the police are doing a very good job, I'll tell you that. If you notice, many of the police are smiling at us, and they're friendly, because they know that they also are part of the 99%, just as we are. They know that we're fighting for them and for their children. And if we don't wage this fight now, our children have no future. They won't have water to drink. They won't have clean air to breathe. So this is what we have to do.
From what you're saying, I mean, when Ken Mayers and Ward Riley dropped that upside-down American flag, the police came over and they told them, you mean we can't drop an American flag in the Senate office building? And the police laughed and he walked away.
The upside-down American
upside
flag,
down.
Just so everybody knows, is not a disrespect symbol. It is a symbol of distress.
Right.
When you fly the American flag upside down, it is a symbol of distress. And this country is in distress. And we are in distress. And it has got to end. It has got to change. And we do not believe that person sitting in the White House, that person who has continued the policies of wars, who has bailed out the banks. We do not believe that person when he says change, you can believe it. That is not change we can believe.
We can name him Obama.
Yes, Obama, right. I didn't even want to mention him by name. You know, but he is not giving us, and he will not give us change we believe in, because we know who he works for. We know who he represents. He represents the 1%. He does not represent the 99%, but we do.
Now, what do you think of the, you know, the Democratic Party is jumping on this thing and saying they support this and all this. What do you think of that?
We do not believe in the Democratic Party. The Democratic Party has done the same thing as the Republicans. It's the Republicrats. They are one and the same. We never have a choice. You have a choice between two multimillionaires that represent the same corporate state. That is the choice that people have. So they have no choice. So effectively, there is no democracy in action. This is not a democracy. You
so
do not.
You can.
We came here to stop business as usual.
What'd
we
you
came
do?
Here.
How many of you?
Oh, maybe there were 300, 400, 500, I don't know, I didn't count, you know. But there were quite a few. Whatever it is, we represent millions, and we're connected with all the occupation movements going around the country right now, and they're rising up, and people are tired of the wealth, their money, their blood, sweat, and tears going into wars, going into the pockets of the corporate elite. Well, meanwhile, we don't have schooling, we don't have housing, we don't have jobs, we don't have jobs with decent wages.
Who are you and where are you from?
Who am I? My name's Tara Kalf, and I'm with Veterans for Peace. And we believe in ending this policy of this foreign policy of using wars as an instrument of foreign policy. We do not believe in that.
All right. Thanks so much, Tarek.
I get your name on the record.
My name's Tarek Kalf. I'm a member of Veterans for Peace, and I'm here with this occupation, the October 2011 occupation in Freedom Plaza.
Sorry, can you spell the first and your last name, please?
T-A-R-A-K-K-A-U-F-F.
Thank you.